Aeloth. How exciting, we can all level up. He's really good in lore, so I say keep him good with lore. It's got 3 left. How about athletics? New spells. Wow, guys. Okay, I'm most likely going to cut this episode in half then, because we need to do this. We need to look at all these spells, and we're almost 40 minutes in. Arcane Dampener. Creates a nullifying field of antagonistic magical energy around the chosen point, suppressing all beneficial effects on enemies in the area of effect. Awesome. Arduous Delay of Motion. We can pick 2 of these as well. Alters the perception of time for enemies in the area of effect, lowering their speed and movement. Okay, so it's like a slow spell. Console Heart's Draining Touch. The caster's hand becomes a toxic parasite, causing corrosive damage to the target, weakening it and leeching a portion of its endurance. Kind of don't like the idea of him getting in melee range, so no to that one. Crackling Bolt. Lightning Bolt. Caster becomes a living generator for a powerful bolt of electricity that streaks out in a straight line and bounces off of walls, harming anything caught in its path. Careful with that one. Dexterous Alacrity of Motion. Caster draws upon his or her life force to gain an increase to speed and movement while draining his or her own endurance. Okay, so it's like a haste spell and it drains your endurance. Expose Vulnerabilities. Bears the enemy's combat vulnerabilities for all to see, reducing their damage reduction, deflection, and concentration. So minus 5 damage reduction, minus 10 deflection, minus 10 concentration. It's a good debuff. Fireball, yes. Summons a flaming ball of molten earth that explodes at a target location, causing burn damage to all in the area of effect. Kalakoth's Minor Blights. Creates a ball of energy in the caster's hand that can be thrown at an enemy, causing burn, freeze, corrode, or shock damage to anyone caught in the area of effect. Blights are continuously replenished until the spell ends. Okay, I think he can't cast anymore. He has to focus on the blight. Lasts for just over a minute. Lengrass Displaced Image. Causes the caster to appear visually displaced, increasing their deflection and reflex for the duration. Additionally, many deflection and reflex attacks that score hits will be converted to grazes. Minoletta's Bounding Missiles. Summons 3 missiles that pierce to the target and leap to 2 additional targets each. Noxious Burst. Spews forth a poisonous cloud of foulness that causes crow damage and leaves victims sickened. Cool. 32 to 45 corrode and sickened for 13 seconds. Rhyngrim's Repulsive Visage. The caster's face becomes a nightmarish mask of rotting insect-infested flesh or other images of unspeakable terror, causing all nearby foes to become terrified and sickened. I say, kind of say Noxious Burst, and I really go for the direct damage spells, as you guys can see. Let me just look here. And this stuff can all be useful, of course. I'm not doing Draining Touch. Lightning Bolt for another time. I kind of don't like you can't really have the caster do anything else while he has these blights, so Noxious Burst and Fireball, yeah. No new talent unlocks.
How may I help?
I like that this stuff is immediately available. We don't have to rest and memorize, you know, before we do anything. Alright, we're so close to this. Let's go up there. Look at him. 47 points. No. 87 points to go.
I shall be discreet.
It's always a good thing. Something interesting is up here, that's for sure. There's a cart, a wagon of some kind. It's over there. Let's look over here first. Who the hell? Who's here? Wine dregs swirl around the bottom of the clay jar. A hunting bow and 26 golden dukes. I'll take that, thank you. I don't see the owner of this card anywhere. So might as well. Potion of Minor Recovery. Minus 2 duration of active hostile effects over 30 seconds. A Velloon? Velloon's namesake is a yellow-orange fruit found in Old Valia. These clear gemstones bear a similar yellow-orange color and often cut like rubies, sapphires, and emeralds. Most of the world's known Velloon mines have long since dried up, and the stone has become one of the most sought after in recent years. Cool. We take. Alright, I thought, well, sure, we'd find someone up here, I guess. Whoever was here has perished, or fled, or something. Oh, that's not the way down. Around here. Let's see if we can finish off this area. Another 15-20 minutes or so. And then we'll head onward. Oh. A forest troll. Well, if it's just one, they aren't that tough. We could use our fireball. And to think of it, just have us sit here. Have him cast fireball. He's probably gonna move forward.
Yeah.
There's another. There's two. A pogra and a pogra. Can we redirect that? I really want to focus it on the troll, because they're susceptible to fire. Have our fighters come ahead. Have everyone move at least a little ahead. Oh wait, Aloth, no. I canceled that out by making him move. He's the one casting this. Okay.
Hey.
Ah, thank you. Some rock.
Nice. Oh, we needed that, because here they come. And there's a lot of them. There's another troll. And there's two of the... No, three of those Pogra things. This is going to be interesting. Soul Ignition. I guess on this troll. Why not try to take it out? Marked prey. Cool. Oh, she's used up almost all of her stuff by doing that. She needs to get focus back. Do another fireball. You know, is she gonna run up in the middle of it? Let's not mess with that right now. Armor of Faith. Where is he anyway? That's him right there. Good. Good position for him. Fireball. So did those two? So far, we're pretty much okay. Oh, there's a small earth blight here now. Let's see if we can get off a heal. Oh. These things must be summoning them. If he got that off, let's go again. Oh my god, they keep springing up around us. Gotta take care of them. Gaunt's Pledge. Oh boy. Need some help over here. Alright, we got rid of one of them. And that one. Where are you running to? Durance. Down air. Hey. Who just leveled up? Eater. Awesome. Yum. If we survive this. Before he actually goes, let me just... So I can cast some more healing here. Go again for these guys. Hello. We're not very happy with you. Cool durance. Look at all these logs. Huh. Alright, leveling. Leveling stuff. Eater. Eater. How do we say it? Athletics. Survival. Fighter abilities. Vigorous defense. Damage bonus. Yeah, that'd be good. What are the others, I wonder? Dagger. Noble is dagger, mace, rapier, rod, and scepter. Peasant is hatchet, hunting bow, quarterstaff, spear, and armed. Ruffian is blunderbuss, club, pistol, saber, and stiletto. And soldier is arbalest, arquebus, greatsword, pike, and warhammer. And adventurer is estoc, flail, poleaxe, wand, and warbow. And the knight, which we're going to take, includes the battle axe, crossbow, morning star, and sword types. He's using a sword, right? No new talents. It's a stiletto. Will that work? You might want to see about getting him a sword. I don't know. Hold on. What? I took Ruffian? Oh. Well, that's good because he's got a stiletto. Okay, good. I meant to do that by accident. Okay. Durance. Now we want mechanics, definitely. 4 points. I'm gonna save the other 2 points for the next mechanics. No new talents, no new stuff, okay. He can now unlock harder things. If we wanted to, we can head back to Radric's fortress and get to the armory and see what's in there. I think we should rest again. I hate doing it so much. But Canna's messed up. Okay.
Let's see what lies this way.
Let's see.
Sure.
I haven't saved for a long time. Let's skip to 62. Clearing away that fog of war. Not sure why it's called that, actually. The fog of discovery, or the fog of mystery? That would fit better. That would more suit it. No, I don't want that. What's this? A structure of some kind. A sparrow's nest is tucked between two angled slats. Well, I'm not interested in that. Someone's home or an old church or something? Kind of has a church school-like kind of look. Schoolhouse. Let's just fill this out. It doesn't look like we can go in there. I love the little details, like dandelions flying. Who's over... Canna? What are you doing over there, Canna?
Yes?
He never came with us.
Of course.
Of course. I'll give you of course. Alright. Actually, that works, yeah. Okay. We can't go to Aedelwan Bridge from here. That stinks. We need to go to Searing Falls. Well, unless we go out east. Let's just check out Searing Falls first, and then we'll see. Actually, you know, I don't know. I don't know what I'm doing. If we go out this way, might be able to hit that bridge.
Quickly and quietly.
We are. We're gonna hit this first. We're gonna go here another time. We might have a quest that leads us here anyway. Yes, the tab key. Very handy. Okay. Interesting. Well, there's not much here. Let's just head across. And there's no fog of war either. Interestingly enough. I don't think it's necessary to sneak. Could be wrong. Can't go that way. Hello? Commoner. If you need an inn for the night, Goose and Fox has the softest beds and the best ale. Craddock Bridgeman. I guess we can't talk to him. You see a ship being tossed about in a storm-ravaged sea. The swells rise and fall, carrying the ship with them as if it were a toy. This man stands on deck at the helm of the ship while water whips around him. The crew moves about frantically, trying to keep the chaos under control. He barks orders at them, pointing where to go and giving each one a task. The men, while still visibly distressed, seem to calm down when they are given their orders. He instructs the helmsman to resume his duties at the wheel, and rushes to the aid of a crewman who is struggling with a rope attached to one of the sails. The ship crests a wave, going almost vertical in one direction and then immediately again in the other direction. Several of the crew are thrown from their feet, sliding across the deck as the ship is rocks. As the ship rocks? After the well, the swell passes and the ship returns to a relatively normal orientation. The man quickly scans the deck, counting silently. No one has been lost this time, thankfully. He looks in the direction they're headed, seeing no reprieve from the storm in sight. His jaw squared and his upper lip stiffened, he returns to the helm and takes the wheel again. Interesting. And Astran Miramulus. You see a lavishly decorated room, walls hung with tapestries, ornate oil lamps creating a warm, relaxing atmosphere. There are several overstuffed couches covered with silk pillows and an elegant table in the middle of the floor. This woman is seated at the table, sitting across from another woman. They are both well-dressed, their style befitting the room they're in. The other woman's hair is blonde, in stark contrast to this woman's black, and is swept up on her head in a dramatic style. The women speak in an easy, free tone, obviously familiar with one another. Though they each seem to be comfortable in the other's company, a strange nervousness surrounds the blonde woman's actions. She occasionally betrays herself with a light giggle or stammer, hitching over an easy word as she speaks. Her demeanor swings from friendly to shy and back again with no warning. Sounds like she's got a crush on this Astrand. The woman leans back a little in her chair, stretching lightly. As she finishes her stretch, she gently lays her hand next to the other woman's hand, letting their fingers subtly entwine. The second woman stops speaking mid-sentence, inhales sharply, and turns red. She does not, however, move her hand. This woman smiles and moves her hand further over the other, holding it. She then stands, moving around the table toward the blonde woman, whose face shows conflicting emotions of terror and lust. She giggles and pulls her hand out from the other and brings it to her mouth, the red of her face deepening. This woman stops, looking down at her, eyes sparkling. She reaches out and pulls something from the blonde's hair, letting it fall around her shoulders. Then she leans over, brushing her lips lightly from the blonde woman's cheek, resting her mouth against her ear. As she whispers, her hand moves lethally, I guess, down the other woman's body to her waist. The blonde shudders and leans into the hand, eyes closing, cheek pressing against the lips, still whispering at her ear. This woman's hand deftly removes a small bag from the other woman's belt and secrets it under her own cloak at the small of her back. Oh my god. Taking advantage. Pickpocketing her. Then she gently kisses the other woman's cheek and stands again, the smile never leaving her mouth. You dirty little... Okay. Anything to see here? Nope. Besides those two? Have you been to the expedition hall yet? You might find your type of work there. Hey, is a fire godlike. And commoners. The Crucible Knights have been warning everyone to stay out of the catacombs. They're not safe anymore. I'm sure I'll be going there. If you're a scholar, you'll want to visit the Hall of Revealed Mysteries. Excuse me. Excuse yourself. It takes a smooth tongue to solve problems, doesn't it? Here's a fire godlike person, Zoran Zinius Kavik. You see a flurry of matted white hair in an incandescent freeze fire staff before you see the man, cold and wild. He chews a wizened apple slowly, discharging spell after spell into the jumble of villagers screeching their way towards him. Cold flame vents from his nose, and apple seeds shoot out the side of his mouth as he saunters forward, ignoring arrows and curses alike. A desperate twist of his staff and a bullet of force glides through the torso of one assailant and another. A roar blisters his throat as he launches himself into their midst, tearing into their essence with his staff. A pleading hand reaches towards him and quickly falls, ignored. Silence takes hold as the tattered man gathers his prize, a basket of fresh pears. He hums as he eats. What's he do? Kill all these people? Attack everybody? To get pears? Loves his fruit, huh? The Copper Lane Marketplace is everything you could ever want to buy. Some of the plays they put on at the amphitheater are quite good. Okay, we're getting sweeping music going on here. Welcome to Defiance Bay, but watch yourself in our city, you understand? Justiciar. What is it? I'm looking for the Temple of Wodica. Huh. If you say so. It's in the First Fires, just west of Crucible Keep. You won't believe us that we're looking for it? Oh, there's goodies over here.
Light, flame, and sound. We'll keep to ourselves.
Can't go that way. Let's wait until we're not detected and we'll look through this stuff. Fruit! Vegetables. Okay. Okay. Stay tuned for next episode when we enter Copper Lane, which is part of Defiance Bay. Gotta be. We can't even access the world view from here. Alright. Well, see you then, and thanks for watching. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.